Glory in the highest. You know, when we say glory in the highest, we're giving him glory to the highest degree. Optimal glory. Immeasurable. That's why we, with all that we are, we praise his holy name. So let us enter his throne. Heavenly Father, we come before you to praise you. We praise you and we worship you. We put on the garment of praise and we cast off the spirit of weariness. Mm-hmm. Lord, we thank you that your presence is already here. For you are Jehovah Shammah. The Lord is always there. And we thank you for peace that surpasses all our understanding. For you are Jehovah Shalom, the Lord of peace. Oh, we thank you, Lord, for the word that's about to go forth. We thank you for the teaching, Heavenly Father. We thank you for the deposit that you're going to put in all of us, Heavenly Father. And we thank you, Lord, that we're not just going to be hearers of your word, but doers of your word. Anoint the speaker of the house so they may bring forth your unadulterated word, rightly dividing the word of truth. Lord, we thank you for this moment, for this consecrated time, that we can just enter in and just lay all of our burdens down, lay them all at your feet. And we dedicate this worship unto you, for we all long to be a sweet sound unto your ear. And in the mighty name of Jesus, we pray and say, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. 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 Oh, hallelujah. Noel, born of God.
The first Noel, the angels did sing, was to certain poor shepherds in fields as they lay, in fields where they keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so deep. Noel, 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 born is the King of Israel.
Oh, hallelujah. Noel, Noel means born of God. He left the splendors of earth like the to come down like the Son of Man. Hallelujah.
They looked up and saw the star shining in the east beyond them far, and to the earth it gave great light, and so it continued both day and night. No
exalt him, for he is the King of kings and the Lord of lords. He is the Alpha and the Omega. He's the beginning and the end.
And by the light of that same star, three wise men came from the country far to seek a king was their intent, and to follow the star wherever it went. Noel, 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 born is the King of Israel. Noel, 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 born is the King of Israel.
Oh, he's the King of kings and the Lord of lords. Oh, hallelujah. He is Noel, born of God. Hallelujah. Oh, and he's a firm foundation. He's a firm foundation in our life. Hallelujah. Take this moment to just dedicate it to him.
worthy of every song we could ever sing, worthy of all the praise we could ever bring, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, all we live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. We live for you. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me.
He's worthy, worthy of it all. Worthy, worthy. Lift your hands and worship him.
Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath he could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me.
Oh, lead me, lead us with your love, Lord. And we thank you, Lord, for the crushing and the pressing, because you're making new oil. You're making new wine. Hallelujah. Through the trials, through the tribulations, they build our character so that he can mold us and use us for his glory. So we just yield to him as yielded vessels. Let him know. Let him know. Hallelujah.
In the crushing, in the pressing, you are making new wine. In the soil I now surrender, you are breaking new ground. So I yield to you. To your careful hand, vessel. Make me an offering. Make me whatever you want me to be. I came here with nothing, but all you have given me. Jesus, bring new wine out of me.
Oh, hallelujah.
In the crushing, in the pressing, you are making new wine. In the soil I surrender. You are breaking new ground. You are breaking new ground. So make me a vessel. Make me an offering. Make me whatever you want me to be. I came here with nothing, but all you have given me. Jesus, bring new wine out of me. Jesus, bring new wine out of me. Jesus, bring new wine out of me. Where there is new wine, there is new
sanctifying us.
Where there is new wine, there is new power, there is new freedom, and the kingdom is here. I lay down my old flesh to carry your new fire today. So make me an offering. Make me whatever you want me to be. God, I came here with nothing, but all you have given me. Jesus, bring new wine out of me. Jesus, bring new wine out of me. Jesus, bring new wine out of me.
Oh, hallelujah. He's making new wine out of each and every single one of us. He's making it sweeter so that we may bear good fruit. Because we need to bear good fruit during these last days. For this world needs love. For this world needs meekness and gentleness and kindness. Hallelujah. Oh, we thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Holy Spirit, for your presence. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Do you feel his presence? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. We praise you, Father. We just worship you, Lord. We just thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We just want to worship you, Lord. We just want to praise you, Father. We just want to worship
you, Father God, for the joy that you give us, Father God. Fill us, Father God, to an overflow, Father God. We thank you for what you have started and what you will bring to completion, Heavenly Father. Father, we praise your holy name, for you and you alone are the one who can set us free, Father God. Father God, we thank you, Father God. We thank you, Father God. We thank you, Father God. And we praise your holy name, Father. We extol you. Yes, Heavenly Father, we magnify your name in this place. For you are the name that's above all names,
yes,
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Jesus. Oh, Father God, you've not abdicated the throne, Lord, but you are there and you are present, Father God. We scream holy, Father God. We cry holy, Father. We cry holy, Father God. Father, thank you, Father God, for strengthening us, Father God. Thank you for being our banner, Father God. Thank you, Father God, that we can call upon you, Father God. Oh, Father, we just thank you, Father God. Praise your holy name, Father. We worship you in spirit and in truth, Father God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Lord, hallelujah. Praise you, Father. Come on and give him some praise. Come on and worship him, church. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father. We just want to worship you, Lord. In your presence, Lord. In your presence, Father. We thank you, Lord, for the spirit of exhortation. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord, for the spirit of exhortation in the church for the body of Christ. We are people that are growing tired. And we know, Lord, you said there would be times of refreshing for the body of Christ. We wait upon those precious times. And we thank you, Lord, as you're refreshing us right now. We feel the refreshing presence of the Holy Ghost in the church. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you. Brother Christian, the Lord says he's going to use you, brother. He's going to use you, brother. He loves you, brother. Lord says he's going to use you, brother. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. He's here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Father. Worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He says, I know. Hallelujah. He says, I know. Hallelujah. He says, I got you, my son. I got you. Hallelujah. Oh, my Lord. Lord says, he's sitting right next to you, sister. He says, all is well. All is well. I have not forgotten about you. I have not forgotten about you. He says, you've entered into a rest. You're resting right now. He says, I got you, my daughter. There it is, sister. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There it is. He says, you need this tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo, it's getting stronger. Hallelujah. Woo. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo. Harkoshinia. Yeshinamakini Hanama. There it is. The anointing of the Holy Ghost. Oh, oh, he loves you. Oh, he loves you. Oh, he loves you, Lord. Oh, he loves you. Oh, hallelujah. Woo. The joy of the Lord. Hallelujah. The joy of the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. The anointing. It's the anointing. Your heart's cry is, all I want to be is in the Lord's presence. All I want to be is in the Lord's presence. I want more of you. I want more of you. I want more of you. More of you. Oh, hallelujah. Woo! Fresh oil. Fresh oil. Fresh oil. Fresh oil. Fresh oil coming upon you right now, brother. In the name of Jesus. The Lord said he's loosening it right now. Hot oil coming upon you right now, brother. Fire, fire, He said, fresh fire, my son. Ooh, hallelujah. Rory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Do y'all feel the anointing? The anointing is in the church. Hallelujah. Ooh, he says, you need a little joy, my daughter. Hallelujah. Everything's going to be all right. Hallelujah. There is joy coming to your spirit. Joy. Joy. He says, I'm going to start putting an expectancy in your spirit, my daughter. Expecting. Hallelujah. I don't know how you're going to do it. Or how it's going to be done, my God in heaven. He says, but I'm going to do it. Hallelujah. A sweet anointing coming upon you right now, sister, in a mighty way. In the name of Jesus. The Lord says, there it is, there it is. Hallelujah. There it is in Jesus' name. Lordati. Shoratariyataba. Oh, hallelujah. Korya shanama. Rotor. Shora tatakardis sietanama. Shora papardis sietanama. Oh, hallelujah. Kora papardi. Shodordi. Pola paleti. Oh, sanama. Just worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. We just praise you, Father. This is a Holy Ghost service. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Whatever he wants to do. Thank you, Lord.
Jesus, thank you.
Thank
you. Frondere profasere. Brandere prekesere, prekesere, prekesere. Onara mala sarata, onara yandare sele. Fondere kiri, frondere kra. Frandere frosse, frondera grandarata. Rondara landare, rarandare seritara. Rondere, rondere, re. Rondere, rondere, re. Rondara faresere proca. Bronga, ronga, bronga, ronga. Bronga, ronga, rasarote. Uriambra, sele, cariate. Rondere, bra, brandero, furiase.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Refreshing the body of Christ right now. Refreshing the body of Christ. Refreshing the body of Christ. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessings over the worship team up here. Hallelujah, Lord. Oh, Lord, we love you, Lord. Ooh, hallelujah. Lord said, fresh fire. He said, fresh fire. Hallelujah. Ooh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. He says it's been almost unbearable. Hallelujah. I'm raising a standard this very night. Hallelujah, Lord, oh Lord. Fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire in the Holy Ghost. There it is, sister. Hallelujah. There it is, sister. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Woo! Thank you, Lord Jesus. Fresh fire, fresh fire, fresh fire. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Woo! Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Shorti kasanama. Eto dianama. Tokanama. Lord says, in the Holy of Holies, we're there, right there. Some of you are touching the hem of his garment right now. He says, reach out and touch the hem of his garment. For I am here, saith the Lord, to meet every need that you have. He says, reach out, reach out. Hallelujah. For I am here. I am here. I am here, saith the Lord. Armin, the Lord says he loves you. He says he loves you. He says, I know you by name, my son. He says, you belong to me. Hallelujah, Lord. We love you, Lord. Oh, we love you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Sister Zoe, the Lord said your living situation is about to change. Oh, hallelujah. The heart's cry. You got some things you've been seeking the Lord about. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, we love you, Lord. My Lord, I love you, Lord. Sister Teresa, the Lord says you're just glad to be here. He says, I'm just glad to be a part of all that's going on right now. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Hallelujah. Oh, we thank you, Lord. Everybody can be seated if you can. In Jesus' name we pray. Everybody said amen, 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 amen. We might as well get used to that because that's what we're going to be doing in heaven, right? 24 elders up there in heaven always worshiping the Lord. Can I get an amen? Amen. Praise Jesus. I said, Lord, did you want us to stay there? He says, no, it's time to get into my word. I said, okay, Lord, we're going into your word. If you wanted us to stay there, we'd stay there, right? Now we're going to move on. Praise Jesus. How many felt the presence of God tonight? Amen. It's good to come to church, amen? Doesn't matter how you're feeling throughout the day, but we don't do this because of a feeling. Amen. We walk by faith and not by sight. I'll say it again. We walk by faith and not by sight. We don't dictate or allow what's going on in our lives to dictate where our faith is and where it needs to be. Amen. We continue to look up from where our help comes from, even though sometimes we may not feel like coming to church, feel like getting into the presence of God, feel like getting into the Word of God. Amen. But when you show up, you're so glad you came. Amen? Because it's not like church as usual. But we come with an expectancy waiting for the move of God to happen when we come into this place. Hallelujah. So I want to welcome everybody tonight to the Hand of God Ministry Community Bible Study. Did I say that right? Community Bible study. Welcome to those that are watching online with us. You're going to be blessed. We're going into part five of It's Harvest Time. We got a new page to hand out tonight. So everyone, she's going to come by and Pastor's going to give y'all a new sheet to pass out. It's going to be good tonight. We're still talking about It's Harvest Time. We're talking about tithing. We're talking about offering. We're talking about seed giving. We're talking about giving, giving, giving. Amen. And we love to give around here. Hallelujah. Me and Pastor got a hold of that revelation a long time ago. And we have never lacked our want for anything, even before having a church, even before coming and becoming pastors and having a church building. We always tithe and we always offered. And we've always seen the hand of God move on our behalf. Hallelujah. We've heard story after story where Christians come and they're planning and they're consistent in their tithes and some circumstance hits the home. How many knows storms will come? Hallelujah. But storms should not determine whether or not you're going to pull your seed out of the ground. Are you hearing me, church? Because storms are always going to come. Trials are always going to come into the Christian's life. And you got to remember, it could be at that very moment that whatever's hitting your house at that very moment, that God wants you to keep the seed in the ground. And I was talking to Pastor probably a couple of days ago about this very thing, that I can almost see in the spirit that some Christians have their seed in the ground. It's coming up, the ear in the corn, if you know anything about agriculture, and it's starting to get to that place where it's about to give off fruit. And as soon as the fruit comes, a great storm comes, and your faith is tested greatly. The refrigerator dies. My kid needs to get the tuition. I don't know what's going to happen. Dennis comes in. Emergency happens. I get it. Amen? Amen. It's at that very moment that the plant, whatever's coming out of the ground, is about to start to bloom, and you take it right out of the ground, and the Lord says, oh, my gosh, they were right there, and they pulled it right up. There has to be a consistency when you're tithing and when you're giving to the house of God and to the kingdom of God. Amen? Amen. Do you have your sheets there? And for you online watching, just follow us. We're going to be in the Word. And we're going to be at the top of page 15. And they may not go in order, like if you have 8, 9, and then we're 15, 10. Don't worry about all the numbers. All of this material we're grabbing from our Bible college so that y'all are here being blessed. Y'all are being so blessed with so much here. Amen. And so it says on the top of page 15, don't read the tithe, one-tenth belongs to God. That's going to be for Pastor next week. But listen to where it says, pertinent questions concerning tithing. And number one, it says, why should I tithe when my tithe is so small? I love that first question already. Because so many Christians in their mind think that there has to be a certain amount to get God's attention. God doesn't operate the way we operate. Amen? Amen. If you only have a dollar and that's your income, even kids, if that's their allowance, $10 a week, you got to teach them that that dollar still has value when they're giving their tithes and they're giving their offering onto the house of God. Amen. So it doesn't really matter if it's small or if it's large. You have to be obedient to the tithing principle. It's all giving principle when it comes to giving. Amen? Are you with me tonight? We love talking about money around here. Amen? We're going to continue to talk about it in this ministry. We will not back up from it. Amen? It says, should you tithe? You should tithe because God commanded it. Jesus taught it. Hallelujah. It's biblical. I'll say it again. It's biblical. I'll say it again. It's biblical. I'll say it one more time for those watching online and all the doubters. It's biblical. Amen. Old Testament, and it made it through the cross into the New Testament. Amen. I'm trying not to preach. Give it a teaching tonight. The amount is what? Irrelevant. Scripture tells us, and I'm going to explain a little more about that in a minute. Let every man lay by as God has prospered him. If you have your Bibles, I want you to go with me to 1 Corinthians chapter 16, and we're going to start in verse 1. This is very important, because the Apostle Paul is talking to the church at Corinth. He's talking to the Corinthians, amen? He's talking to the church in Houston. He's talking to Houstonians, amen? Because something is happening right now in Jerusalem. And he goes to the Corinthian church, but why is he going to the church at Corinth? Because the church at Corinth is blessed. They got a hold of the tithing message. And financially, they have been blessed in this church. So the Apostle Paul is the one that gave birth to this church. And we're talking about tithing, we're talking about offering, we're talking about seed sowing. And I want to show you some giving principle here so that you can have a better understanding for yourself. Amen? Amen. Do you see the top of it, what it says on your heading there? It says the collection for who?
Jerusalem.
In verse 1, now regarding your question about the money being collected for God's people in Jerusalem. Verse 1, you should follow the same procedure I gave to the churches, plural, in Galatia. Now I want you to stop there because I want you to see something. The Apostle Paul is talking to the church at Corinth, and he's saying, look, before I get there, I want you to take up a collection for those in Jerusalem. So when I get there, I can take your collection that you gave, the seed that you sowed, I can take it to Jerusalem because they need help in Jerusalem right now. Amen. Why? Because they were being persecuted. They weren't able to work because they were receiving so much persecution from their countrymen because a lot of them had converted to Christianity. And so they were being excommunicated out of their community, so they weren't able to work. And a lot of them couldn't go to the synagogue anymore because they were kicked out. So they were not considered poor, but they were experiencing this poverty because of the intense persecution around them. Poor, amen? Because we get caught up a lot of times when you see poor, poor, poor. We got to help the poor, the poor, the poor. I'll settle that question so that way you have a better understanding when it comes to reaching out to the poor. Amen? Amen? And this is the way it works. Let's say as an individual, as your Christian walk, as you go along in this life, and you're walking, and let's say you see a nail in the road. What do you do when you see that nail sticking up? Most likely you're going to pick the nail up so no one else gets hurt. And you're going to take it and you're going to put it in the trash because the opportunity was laid before you at that very moment. Okay, you got me. The thing is that because I saw the nail in the road, I'm not going to take up a cause and go and start picking up every nail in the city. Some of y'all catch that. When a poor person is in front of me or is presented or the opportunity presents itself, I'm going to do it as the Lord leads me. Are you hearing me? By the Holy Ghost. And you have to know you have to have discernment when it comes to helping the poor. All right. And the Apostle Paul is taking up a collection. He says, I commanded the churches in Galatia. And when you read the book of Galatians, you think that it's Galatia. It's one church. It's three of them in that area. And when he's talking about churches, it's plural. He's talking about the churches in the south region of Asia Minor, where it's Greece, present-day Turkey. Amen? Iconium, Lystra, and Derbe were the three churches that Apostle Paul established on his first missionary church. And he's saying, I wrote a letter to them already, and they're already collecting some things so that I can take some relief over to the church in Jerusalem. How many knows that's scriptural to give for someone else so they can have relief being led by the Holy Ghost? Seed sowing, giving. And so the Apostle Paul is, let me keep going. Go with me to verse 2. And he says, on the first week,
Everybody say first day of each week. What is the first day of each week? That is Sunday. So we have church on Sunday. Why do we come to church on Sunday? Well, I don't have to come to church on Sunday because I celebrate Christ every day. Don't fall into that, amen? That's erroneous. Jesus was resurrected on what day?
Sunday.
Jesus appeared to the disciples on what day?
Sunday.
The day of Pentecost was on what day?
Sunday.
Something's going on Sunday, right? Amen? Come on now. That's our Sabbath rest.
Amen.
Are you hearing me? Our Sabbath rest is in Christ and what he's done. We come on Sunday to celebrate and remember what Jesus Christ has done. Because if we start skipping our Sundays, guess what? We may forget what he's done for us. That's why the Bible repeats itself over and over and over and over again. Because why? Flesh forgets. We're still in this sinful nature. Well, I heard this message last week. Well, this week it sounds a little different. I may have been going through something last week, and I couldn't really hear quite well, Pastor.
Amen.
So I'm hearing it again, and boy, it's hitting me all kinds of ways right.
Amen.
Amen. I may have been in sin. My conscious mind may have been weighed down. I was going through repentance. I couldn't hear anything because God was dealing with me. But now my conscience is clear.
Amen.
Why do we become forgetful? Conscience sometimes is burdened too much. Amen. Are you hearing me? The only one that can cleanse the conscious minds of men is the blood of Jesus Christ and what he's done. That's why the blood of animals was not good enough. Come on now. On the first day of each week, on Sunday, you should each put aside a what? Portion of the money you have earned. He says, don't wait until I get there and then try to collect it all at one time. Hallelujah. Now, I want you to hear this. Now, this is in 2 Corinthians. Now, just listen to this scripture. 2 Corinthians 8:4 says this. They begged us again and again for the privilege of sharing in the gift for the believers in Jerusalem. Now, I want you to grab a hold of that. Every time you tithe and you offer into this church, into this ministry, for the work of God, right now we're collecting seed for the building fund. That's going towards what we did to pay everything we did by constructing this building for the people of God. Amen?
Amen.
You don't see everything that comes into the ministry that's going out of the ministry. But because you bring in your tithes and your offerings and your seed, there's moments where we go and we visit another ministry. Pastor may be in a lower part of the city, may not be as well off. And the Lord will put it in our hearts, I want you to sow $500 into that ministry. And we're able to do that. Every one of you have a share in that offering.
Amen.
Woo! Come on now.
Amen.
That's good. Every time we help someone get on their feet that's come through this ministry that you know not of, we've helped them in housing. We've put their, we put groceries in the refrigerator. We've paid 2 months rent just so they can get back on their feet because tragedy has hit their home. Whatever has happened in life, we step in for the moment. And then God will say, okay, you're done. That's all. Now back up. You have to know that. You have to understand how and when to reach out and then when to back up and say, Lord, I'm done with my labor. That's it.
Amen.
That's the wisdom of God. And so the Apostle Paul, the people in Corinth were begging the Apostle Paul, this gift, this seed that you're coming to collect, I'm begging you, please allow me to put some of my money in there. I want to share in that blessing that's going over to Jerusalem. I want to be a part of that seed. Do you hear me, church? It's all the giving principles, even though you don't see the word tithing in there. It's all giving to the house of God and to the work of God.
Amen.
And the Apostle Paul is reminding us here at the Hand of God Ministry, if you saw someone coming in here and we're taking an offering somewhere else and someone's saying, Pastor, please hold on. Don't take it just yet. Let me get my money in there because I want that to be blessed as well. How many of us do that? We got some good givers here, though. Are you with me? So let's go back to our page. Why should I tithe when my tithe is so small? You should tithe because God commanded it and Jesus taught it. It's biblical. The amount is irrelevant. Scripture tells us, let every man lay by as God has prospered him. 1 Corinthians 62, New Testament. Now, I want to go to the story of the widow's mite because this is powerful, church. And I want to read out of the New Living Translation. So go with me to Mark chapter 12. And we're going to start in verse 41. Are y'all enjoying this tonight? How many know this is teaching night? Amen. Hallelujah. Are we there? I'll probably get there a little faster. I know I'm using a tablet, so forgive me. I still know my Bible, though. I know where Mark is. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's read. And it says in verse 41, Jesus sat down near where? How many have seen that? It says the collection box. You know what the collection box is, right? That's the tithe and offering box right there. It says that Jesus sat down right next to the collection box. I want y'all to see this. Here's the collection box. And Jesus sat right next to it, looking it over, watching everything that's going in. Jesus watching everything you're putting into the tithe box. That should alarm some of us. Hallelujah. Even online, that should alarm us. Because Jesus is watching the amount that you're putting in. He's concerned about the collection box. He's watching and taking everything into account. God keeps a good set of books, church. So if you've been consistently tithing in this ministry, guess what? All you're doing is waiting for your harvest to come in. And don't let your faith grow weary, knowing it's coming. Lord, it's coming and I'm expecting it. I'm a consistent tither, but yet I don't see my harvest. That means something else is going on and you're out of the will of God somewhere else. Amen. Did you hear me? Amen. I know that was a lot to take in. Say it again, Pastor. I'll say it again. I'm a consistent tither. I've been tithing. I'm not getting no return whatsoever, and I'm following everything concerning tithing. That means you as an individual are outside of the will of God somewhere else. Sin is sin. Sin is sin, amen? It'll stop the blessings up. You cannot outsmart God. I gave my money, but I'm over here sinning over here. God's still going to bless me. No, he won't. It doesn't work that way, church. We've had Christians tell us that. Well, I gave. Well, let's keep reading. Verse 41, Jesus sat down near the collection box in the temple and watched as the crowds dropped in their money. Many rich people put in large amounts. They were doing it for show. Then a poor widow came and dropped in two small coins. The value today's currency would be a dollar. And Jesus called his disciples to him and said, I tell you the truth, this poor widow has given more than all the others who are making contributions. For they gave a tiny part of their surplus. But she, poor as she is, has given everything she had to live on. Jesus is just teaching the disciples that though the rich people came in and they gave a big amount, they didn't give the right amount. They didn't give the heart amount. They didn't give with the right attitude. They came simply to show off and to let everybody see how much they were putting into the collection box. Well, I make $30,000 a month, but I'm putting in what it appears to be $500 or whatever the amount that I'm putting in there seems like a large amount. It seems like I want everyone to notice what I'm putting in there, but it's really not the right sacrifice that God is calling me to do at this moment. And so the Lord is teaching his disciples that don't be like man and start looking in the carnal sense of who's given what, Because God looks at the heart. God sees the heart. And wherever you are, doesn't matter if this one's further along than you are. If you're giving the right amount and the other one's giving a small amount, but it's the right amount, God still sees both the same. Are you hearing me, church? God will meet you where you are. We're talking about it doesn't matter how small the amount is. You just got to start somewhere, church. Well, I don't make a lot because, you know, they're going to see my two pennies be put in there, which values at a dollar. And God's not going to really take notice of that. He will take notice of that. You got to start somewhere, church. Don't despise small beginnings. I'll say it again. Don't despise small beginnings. All right, let's go back to your page. It says God sees the heart. That makes all the difference, not the actual amount. Hallelujah. In any case, he's saying the tithe, the 10% belongs to God, whether it's a large or small amount. Number two, is the storehouse always the church? I'll say it again. Is the storehouse always the church? Yes or no? Everybody says yes. Where's the storehouse? The storehouse is where you're being fed. That's your storehouse. Amen. You bring whatever that God has given you, whatever's coming to your hand, you bring it into the storehouse, and that's your storehouse. The storehouse is the church. Now, there's a lot of televangelists that won't preach it that way. They'll tell you that the storehouse isn't the church. Why? Why do they say that? That's it, exactly, because the storehouse is where your local branch that you belong to, so that we can continue to reach out into the community as God has purposed us. Hallelujah. Come on now. Is the storehouse always the church? Yes. This was covered in lesson one, but bears repeating. Not many Bible scholars would differ on the point that the New Testament ministry succeeded that of the Levitical priesthood. Let's keep going. When Paul claimed that they who preach the gospel should receive their living from the gospel. 1 Corinthians 9:14. Go with me real quick. This is one of those subjects, church, that Pastor and I preach at least once or twice a year. This has been since we've opened our ministry. Amen, Pastor? Amen. The reason being is because it's the most misunderstood subject in the body of Christ when you're dealing with money. Can I get an amen? It is riddled throughout New Testament, though. So I want y'all to see this because you're going to be blessed when you read it out of your New Living Translation. Just smacks you right between the eyes. Because the translation is just, you can't really misinterpret what he's trying to say here. Amen? Amen. So let's read in verse 14. In the same way, the Lord ordered. It wasn't a suggestion, but it was ordered. It was ordered that those who preach the good news should be supported by those who benefit from it. Yet I have never used any of these rights, and I'm not writing this to suggest that I want to start now. In fact, I would rather die than lose my right to boast about preaching without charge. And I want you to stop there. A lot of Christians will take that interpretation and say, well, the Apostle Paul didn't charge. Did you read that? He says, I would rather preach to you and not charge you in a sense to put a stumbling block in front of you. The reason he said that at this time, you have to know your Bible. You have to understand where Apostle Paul was coming from at that very moment. He was speaking to the Corinthians because there was what was known as hucksters trying to come in and pretend, and they were taking money from the Corinthians. And they were telling them things that were not lined up and giving them a different way, and the Corinthians were gladly giving them money. Different preachers coming in, prophets coming in, telling them what their itching ears want to hear. And so the Apostle Paul is saying to cut under the feet of those who are saying they're just like me at this very moment. Though I haven't gotten a direct revelation from God, I'm not going to charge you by taking your tithes so that way I can show you at this moment, because the gospel is being birthed at this very moment. The church is being birthed and it's on its way to a place where I got to make sure that it stays right here where it's at. Can you hear me? And if you go into the next Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, all the way to the end, he says, forgive me for doing this to you. Y'all got to know that. He says it later on in the second book. He says, forgive me for not charging you and doing this thing. It was only for a little season that I did this. Is that good? He says, yet preaching the good news is something I can boast about. I'm compelled by God to do it. How terrible for me if I didn't preach the good news. He says, if I were going to do this on my own initiative, I would be deserving a payment, but I have no choice, for God has given me. Now keep going. He says, what then is my pay? Now go all the way down. Y'all gonna love this. Go back to your page now. I want to show you something. We're going to hold off there for a second. He says, is the storehouse always? Yes, yes. Go with me, 1 Corinthians 9:14. You already read that. He was actually commenting on the way in which the Levitical priesthood was sustained. And 1 Corinthians 9:9 is a quotation from Deuteronomy 25:4. Thou shalt not muzzle, hinder the ox when he treadeth out the corn, the one doing the work. Paul also used Deuteronomy 25:4 in support of his claim that they who labor in the word and doctrine are worthy of double honor. Stop there. What does all that mean, Pastor? Oh my gosh, Pastor, I'm drowning. Don't drown on me now. There's a lot of word, I know. But I want you to hear me. The Apostle Paul was a scholar. He was what was known as a lawyer. He knew the word of God better than all his counterparts. Better than the Sanhedrin, better than the Pharisees, better than the Sadducees. And he knew the Old Testament. He was seasoned and he was skilled in the Old Testament. And he's using Old Testament scriptures as types and shadows to not muzzle the ox while it treads out the grain. Muzzling the ox is taking the ox and muzzling the animal while it's treading out the grain, breaking up the stony ground in your lives as we plant seed in your lives. You don't muzzle the ox as he's treading out the grain while we're sowing seed into your life. For the one who does it deserves what? Double honor. For the laborer is worthy of his hire. When you sow, you should expect a return. Those that have been tithing and offering and seed sowing, continue to do so, because I prophesied all the way in the beginning of January. If you remember, even before the pandemic hit, even before everything started coming into our country, I said the year of Jubilee. Do y'all know what the year of Jubilee is? It refers to blessings. It refers to payment. That's right, debt cancellation, all types of blessings that comes into the Christian's life. And God says it's time to open up the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing so great you won't have room enough to take it in. He says continue to stay in faith. I'm going to finish this last part and we're going to close up. Paul also appealed to the Leviticus 6:16 when he asked, do you not know that they which minister, do you not know that they, pastors which minister about holy things, live of the things of the temple, things that you bring in, they that which wait at the altar, we're waiting at the altar, are partakers with the altar. I don't know how anybody can misinterpret this. Even so has the Lord ordained that they which preach the gospel should live of the gospel.
Oh, that's good.
The sacrificial system of the Levitical priesthood had been abolished by the very sacrifice of Christ. We know that. Therefore, according to the Apostle Paul, the only way the minister of the gospel could live was by what? Storehouse tithing. We're able to continue to do what me and Pastor are able to do. We don't have to go and get vocational jobs. so that we can provide for ourselves, because we have such a good church that understands tithing and giving. Amen. That we can continue to be about the holy things here. Amen. At church. Amen? Amen. We're going to finish it up. I'm going to go all the way through with y'all. Number three. Y'all going to have to get y'all second win here. Amen. Come on now. Should one's tithe be sent to any ministry that upholds God's word, such as a Christian organization or a TV ministry? One cannot bypass the teaching in God's word and send the tithe anywhere he chooses, whether it be your favorite minister on TV or the church where you once attended. Are you hearing me, church? Someone blesses you. You're visiting a church. You're watching a TV evangelist. And Lord, they stirred me up and I want to bless them. Everything after your tithe, your offering, your seed, you're listening to something, it truly blessed you, you want to give, that's seed sowing. And you're okay to do that, church. Ah. Did y'all hear me? Amen. It says here that the church is the fountainhead for all Christian enterprises. To give the tithe to the church is to honor the church of the Lord Jesus Christ. To tithe directly to any other enterprise, however valid, is robbing the storehouse of its potential to reach out to the community where it is located. However, offerings beyond the tithe is an exception, while the tithe goes directly to the storehouse. If someone has an offering above the tithe and is led by the Holy Spirit to place it elsewhere, God will honor his giving. However, each individual should first take seriously the needs in his own church before you start taking seed, because we have a need right now concerning the building fund. Amen. So you know your church has a need right now. And that's all the Apostle Paul is laying down right here. The churches in Jerusalem took up a collection. We've been talking about tithe, the 10% of everything that is brought into your hand belongs to God. The offering is the blessing that's between you and God. Amen? Seed sowing is everything on top of your tithe and offering. Once that's done, let's say I've already got my tithe and offering in. I'm in this service and I have a stirring in my heart to give something else. You can't outgive God. Are you hearing me, church? You cannot outgive God. Part five, it's harvest time. Let's close our Bibles. Let's everybody stand. I know there's a lot of teaching tonight. It'll get to where it needs to go when you get out. It'll start to go where it needs to be. Hallelujah. And we'll see. We'll see if it's enough. Maybe God will move us on. Maybe he'll keep us there. But we'll know when it's time to move on, that the Lord says, okay, it's time to let that settle. We can't give you 6 months worth of Bible teaching concerning tithes and offerings. Little by little. The Bible says here a little, there a little. Brick upon brick. Precept upon precept. There's no way to get everything you can in one service when you come into a ministry like this. Amen. We're a word ministry. Father, we thank you, Lord. We praise you and we worship your holy name. I thank you, Lord, for those that came by the way of this ministry tonight. We felt your presence in the beginning, Father. And we thank you for the word. Your word is life to those who find it, medicine, healing to all of our flesh. You said the word shall go over us and make us clean through and through. We thank you, Lord, and praise your holy name. We thank you for the anointing of the Holy Ghost that destroys every yoke and lifts every burden, Father. Lord, I speak peace over the body of Christ. And I thank you, Lord, for the refreshing outpouring of the Holy Ghost this night. As you bless your people, Father, we send the word forth to each and every household standing today. Peace, Lord, upon their homes during this season, Father. The Lord says, if you want to touch, come up. If you want to touch from the Holy Ghost, just come up. I'm going to lay hands real quick. Just a touch. Come on up, guys. Just a touch from the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Father. While you're out, grocery shopping, Christmas shopping, you're at work, family, whatever the case may be this year, stay close to the Lord. Stay real close to the Lord. Stay as close as you can. Because people, you're going to have to extend mercy. You're going to have to extend a lot of grace, a lot of patience, because they may not have what you have. And they may not have the understanding that you have when it concerns faith. So give it to them this year. I've had to do that. It's been hard. Hallelujah. Father, right now, a fresh touch from above, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Father, right now, Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Oh, as soon as I laid my hands on you, sister, hallelujah, the Lord said, done. Hallelujah, faith, sister, great faith, hallelujah, he said, tonight is your miracle, sister, hallelujah, thank you, Lord Jesus, I know you feel that, sister, hallelujah, thank you, Lord Jesus, I was not expecting that. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. He says you got some earlier, but you need some more. There it is again. Hallelujah. There it is. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. There it is, too. Woo! Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Woo! Hallelujah. He said, thank you. Oh, hi. Okay, Lord. Hi. Woo! Kor shi. Hi. Already. Woo! Already. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Freshie. There you go, sister. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Father. Worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, roti. Oh, hallelujah. Serious. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father. Whoo. A lot of serious stuff. Hallelujah. Oh, ratia shatapa. Nikashunorati. Oh, there it is, brother. In Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. He says, there it is. He says, I'm stirring it up. Do you feel him stirring? They're stirring it up. He's stirring it up, brother. He's stirring it up. Ah, shoto. Hikishi niyanama. Oh, ratatasha. Very sensitive to the Holy Ghost, brother. You know, conviction, the Lord says, strong in your life, brother. Whoo. Here it is, brother. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Worship you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Worship you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. The anointing. The anointing. The anointing. Jesus' name. Fresh touch. fresh touch. Everything's all right. Everything's okay. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Finances. He says finances are going to change. Shura disintiapa. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He says, oh, yes. I didn't make a mistake. The house you're in, he says, I didn't make a mistake. I don't know why he said that. He said, the house you're in, he didn't make a... No, uh-uh. Mm-mm. Hallelujah. Oh, there's been times, Lord, we made a mistake. This wasn't you. He says, oh, no, my daughter. Woo! He's ministering to you, sister. He's getting all in your prayer. Hallelujah. He loves you, sister. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. You've had that conversation with your husband. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. He says, oh, no, oh, no, oh, no, oh, no. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Lord says, I'm calling you higher. He says, I'm calling you higher. Woo! I'm calling you higher. My son, I'm calling you higher. He says, revelation, understanding, hallelujah, is filling your mind and your spirit. He says, you belong to me, my son. You belong to me, my son. And that's a word to you. I'm going to give you the wisdom. I'm going to give you the knowledge, understand. I'm going to give you the strength to raise your children. In Jesus' name. Jesus' name. All that you've learned, even growing up as a child. Hallelujah. He goes, I'm redirecting everything, rearranging everything, unlearning some things, and relearning some things in me. And that's a word to you by the Holy Ghost. Father, right now, the anointing has increased. Ashura papardi. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Hallelujah. All is well. Continue to pray. Yes, continue to pray for that family member. He says, I've shown you some things. He says, continue. Continue, continue. He says, you're about to see the fruit of your prayer come to pass. That's a word to you. You've been calling them home. It's time. It's time. Ooh, hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Father, right now, I thank you, Lord. A quick work being done in this young man's life. A quick work, Father. In the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Lord, for the anointing of the... Oh, there it is, brother. There it is in Jesus' name. I feel the Spirit of the God. Spirit of the Lord coming upon him. Oh, hallelujah. Oh. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Peace. Overwhelming peace. That is the touch you need right now. Peace. That surpasses all your understanding. I'm giving you peace, my daughter. Peace. Peace in chi. Yeshokoratata. Oriatanama. Koniyanamalidiyatanama. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. From the head to you, to your wife, to your children. The order of God, how He's placed it. Father, right now, release the anointing. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord. As you bless, blessings, blessings, blessing. Blessings, blessings, blessings. In the name of Jesus, the Lord said, blessings, blessings. I'm going to use you for my glory, son. Blessings, blessing. Blessings in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you, Lord. He says, the anointing of the Holy Ghost resting upon you this evening. In Jesus, there it is, brother. In Jesus' name, Lord loves you very much, Army. I know you feel that. That's the presence of God, brother. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Woo, heavy anointing. Man has a call in his life. The Lord says those who have the strongest call on their life get dealt with the strongest, brother. I want you to know that. Strict. And he's hard on those who have a strong call. That's why he's hard on you. That's why they're hard on you. Because of the call of God that's on your life. Amen. Father, right now. In Jesus' name. I release the anointing and the power of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 It just started getting stronger. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Till she can't stand it no more, Lord. Hallelujah. It's the anointing. Yes, there it is, sister. There it is. He said, my hand is upon you. He said, my hand is upon you. He said, my hand is upon you, my daughter. Oh, hallelujah. Thus saith the Lord. Thus saith the Lord. He says, your experience in my presence is about to change. Whew. He says there's going to be a moment, just a suddenly, that'll come upon your spirit, sister, and you're going to know it's him. And you'll begin to weep. You'll begin to laugh. You'll begin to praise. And you'll begin to worship. He says, ever so sensitive to the anointing and the presence of God. Hallelujah. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, every bit of self-doubt being removed in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Give him the confidence he needs, the boldness in the Holy Ghost to know who he is, Lord. The Lord said, you are wonderfully made in his sight, Brother Santiago. Wonderfully made. Oh, Father, right now I release the... There it is, brother. It's the anointing. God told me to tell you he loves you very much, Santiago. And he will protect and he will keep you. Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Jesus' name. Father, I release the anointing. Sister Kimmy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He says, you've been faithful. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Worship you, Lord. Father, I release the anointing. and the power of the Holy Ghost upon my sister. For she has acknowledged you in her heart. She said in her heart, not my will, but thy will be done. Lord's got something special for you, sister. And you'll know this is where you need to place and put your feet to prosper in your life. And that's a word to you by the Holy Ghost. Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father. It's the good work. The good work. The good work I have begun. The good work. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, sister, hallelujah. Shora party. Shikianama. Losatarti. Right before you're about to enter in. Right before you're about to step in. Right before you're about to receive. There always seems to be an interruption. Great. Great, the Lord said, is thy faithfulness. Sure. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. There it is, sister. Hallelujah. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lord loves you very much, sister. There it is. 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 Hallelujah. There it is. There it is. There it is. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Yep. Sitting down and resting in me. That's where he has you right now, sister. Seated in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Woo. Lord said, done. Oh, fine. Show by the deep. Lord, I can dish no nora, papa. Lekash no nora, validish nianama. Thank you, Lord. Clidish no no. Father, we bind up every hindering spirit in the name of Jesus. Cancel every assignment set against us in the name of Jesus. The blood is against you, Satan. And you got to back up in Jesus' name. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Father. We praise you, Lord. Glorify you. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. You gonna lay hands on me, brother? In the name of Jesus. Go ahead. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father. And we praise you, Lord. How many know children need the Spirit of God? They need to be under the anointing. Need to be under the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father. And this mama has done so. She said, for me and my house, we're going to serve the Lord. It wasn't easy. It wasn't easy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Father. Worship you, Lord. He says, watch and see what I'm going to do with your children. And that's a word to you by the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name. Come on and give him a shout. That's shouting ground. Y'all want to know how hard it was? Go talk to Sister Teresa. When she was with us from the beginning. Bringing her kids when they were this big. Tiny, tiny. She did it too. Amen. Sister Isabel. Woo. Hallelujah. It's harvest time. It's harvest time. It's harvest time. He says, when you get it, as soon as it comes into your hand, you give it to your husband. She knows what I'm saying. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Anything I get in my hands, it goes right to the CFO of the church. Amen. And that's Pastor DeLisa. Y'all saw the production she was putting on. You think I would be able to do that? That's not my anointing. That's her anointing. Amen. And you've come to that place, sister. You know where your strengths are. You know where your weaknesses are. You know what the anointing of God has placed on you. The lane that you stay in. Hallelujah. And he says, because of this, I'm going to put it in your hands. You have no problems. Here. There is no, I'm going to put a little aside for myself. Lord said, He says, I want to bless you. It's harvest time. Brother Jesse, it's harvest time. Brother Jesse, it's harvest time. Lord said, it's harvest time, brother. Y'all have waited so long. Lord said, it's harvest time. It may not look pretty, but the Lord says, you weren't going back to FedEx, brother. He says, no. He said, no, brother. He says, you haven't seen nothing yet, my son. What I'm going to do with you concerning your workplace. And that's a word to you by the Holy Ghost. Certain prayers you've offered, brother. Woo, hallelujah. You may not be able to stomp, but he says, your wife's going to do all the stomping for you, brother. She's going to take care of all the stomping for you, brother. Oh, if you could see what I see, brother. Do you see what I see? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I feel a blessing around here. Around this area right here. Blessing. A lot of blessings coming around you, Pastor. Blessings. He says, arrest. Such a rest is going to come to your spirit the next few weeks. All that you have to do is such a strength is going to fill you. Supernatural energy that's going to overtake your body, mind, and spirit, saith the Lord. You won't understand it. Coffee won't do it. Mm-mm. I'll have like 4 or 5 cups and I'm still tired. But when I come into church, I get energized. The Spirit of God will energize the Christian. Amen. And the Lord says, it's coming upon you, right? See the Lord. He says, everything is going to be put where it needs to be put. Everything concerning the program. The Lord says, it's going to be such a blessing. Woo! Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. He said, done in Jesus' name. Done in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father. Hallelujah. It's harvest time. He says, it's harvest time. How many knows Brother Dell's a giver? Give it to me, Lord. I'll give it right back to you. God will bless people like that. Lord, show me your children again, brother. Just came to my spirit right now. He says, I'm working it all right now. I'm working it out. It'll be such a testimony and a miracle beyond what you could ever comprehend or even think or understand what God's going to do concerning your children in New York. Father, I release the anointing and the power of the Holy Ghost in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Peace. Hallelujah. Praise you, Father. God knows exactly what we need as a body of believers. Every time we come into the church, as we yield our very being to His Spirit, we thank you, Lord, it's done. And those who are watching live, if you're tuning in, we lift up every household that's watching and we send peace your way. Peace this season, peace in your home. Those who are tuning in right now, the Lord says blessings upon your household. Peace in your household. I pray that God use those that are watching in this season to be a light. Show forth love. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray, and the church said, amen, amen. You can be seated. Amen, amen. Hallelujah. Sister Teresa.
I'm glad I didn't wear mascara. Oh, my goodness. Isn't that great? It'd be all over the place. All right. Does everybody know what time it is? Yes, time to give, giving time. It's also Christmas time. Christmas right around the corner, that time of the year. It's a magical time when, you know, all those fun goodies that the kids are asking for, and the commercials show all the gizmos and gadgets and everything that we're excited to receive. It's just that kind of expectancy, right? So the kids wake up on Christmas morning and they just expect that they're going to have what they asked for. And so we do it as parents or, you know, humans, right? Because we love them. We give them these good gifts. So let's think about Matthew 7:9-11. And it says, "You parents, if you your children ask for a loaf of bread, do you give them a stone instead? Or if they ask for a fish, do you give them a snake?" Of course not, right? So as people know how to give good gifts to your children. How much more will your Heavenly Father give good gifts to those who ask Him? And guess what? He's a good Father. Even if we don't ask, He's going to give us more than what we could even possibly think or imagine, right? So just think about that next time. And, you know, it's reiterated in Luke 6, 38, where it says, "Give and it will be given to you, a good measure, pressed down, shaken together." So we know that He wants to give us good gifts. We know that if we can tap into His blessings by just experiencing it. If we give, we're going to get in return, and it's going to be more than we gave. So just think about that. It's just tap into that blessing. Sow into His kingdom today. And just think about that during this time. Our God is one that gives us more. He asks us to come with an expectancy. He's a God that exceeds expectations. So just remember that. So if you have your, if you're writing a check, make it payable to the Hand of God Ministry. If you're giving cash, you can use envelopes that are in front of you. If you're giving by debit card, you can use the terminal. If you haven't done so already, you can use it after we dismiss in the hallway right there. If you're sowing seed for the building fund, designate that on that amount on your slips or envelopes. And if you've joined us online and you want to donate, please go to our website, thehandofgodministry.com, and hit that donate tab. If you have them ready, come and bless the Lord. If everyone will just bow your heads and stretch your hands to the offerings. Lord, we know You're sitting here at the offering box. We know that You're watching, and we know that You know our hearts, Lord. We just are so thankful for all of the giving that we're able to do today, that we're building block by block. We're starting with the basics with the tithing, but we're then adding our offering, Lord, because that's when we really are giving it back to You, Lord. And then the seed sowing, Lord, we're asked that You just give seed to the sower, Lord. We all have in our hearts that we want to give so that we can continue to build this church and just prosper in abundance so that Your word can come forth and Your kingdom can continue to just be shine throughout throughout everything we do here at the Hand of God Ministry, Lord. We ask that you just prosper, just abundantly prosper everyone here, Lord, in all areas of their life, physically, spiritually, and financially, Lord. We know that you want to give those good gifts to us, Lord, and we know that we expect a return on this investment that we've provided here today, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Amen. All right. So just some final few words on announcements. Thank you, everyone, for joining on a Wednesday. Maybe it's your first time. We ask that you stop by the Welcome Center and leave a Connect card with us. Friend us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, and subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can stay up to date with all the latest and greatest from our sermons, as well as now being able to watch live. Super Kids, meet Sister Isabel in the children's room for your Kingdom stickers right after the service. And then we'll be back Sunday at 10:30 a.m. for more church. So join us then. You can come by early, stop by the social for some coffee between 9:45 a.m. and 10:25 a.m. So is there anything else, Pastor? Okay. Then we can all stand to be dismissed. Everyone will just join me in prayer as we just come in unity, Lord, as a body of believers, as a body of Christ. We just thank you, Lord, for this word that was poured over us today that was so rich, Lord. And we just ask that you let it saturate and penetrate into those areas in our life where it needs to go, Lord. Let us apply the word and just build, building block by building block, your word, Lord, and just continue to put it into action as we draw closer to you, as we build your kingdom, and just continue to live a life that's going to allow us to prosper and be lined up with your word, Lord. We ask that everything we put our hands to, all of our jobs, our businesses, our homes, our workplaces, Lord, that you just continue to provide a protection, a hedge of protection over all of that and all of our comings and our goings, that we're going to be blessed going and blessed coming, Lord. We know that you are with us. We know we stand on your promises and we stand on your word and we're ready to receive. We come with that expectation, Lord. We thank you for all you've done. We thank you for the pastors, Lord, that you have just divinely brought them to us, Lord, to provide this meat for us and this continuation of just word that comes from them to build us up, Lord, and edify us as a body. We ask all this in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Tell someone you love them on the way out.